I don't think that there was a bigger R&B project or R&B series in our, like, you know, time from like 2010 to 2000, what's about to be 2020, that was bigger than the Chicks tapes. There was no concurring 1, 2, 3, 4. Like, there's not that. There's not that. It is the Chicks tape. Cause who did 4 of them? All I wanna do is get you blown. No one did it. I don't wanna drive, I'm too lit. I just wanna vibe, I'm too blown. You all on my side and the truth is, you just need to slide on me slow. I don't need a drive, I'm too lit. Caught up in a vibe, I'm too gone. Anytime I slide, the truth is, you just need to ride on me slow. I'm feeling sour, but start with the cheddar. You grind with me, we gon' come up together. Pretty days, we gon' stun it together. Cause the Rolls Royce I drive, they come with umbrellas.
Don't worry, don't worry, don't
worry. Tell them niggas Chicks tape in progress, bitch.
What the Chicks tapes are a series of all R&B themed project. The Chicks tape 1 was to sound like early 80s. The Chicks tape 2 was to sound like late 80s. The Chicks tape 3 was to sound like early mid 90s. The Chicks tape 4 was supposed to be late 90s, which brings us to Chicks tape 5. That was stuff that my brothers and my older siblings grew up on and kind of introduced me to. I'm the youngest of 6 kids, and seeing their taste of whatever they grew up on, that's kind of like my, also like my memorabilia of the 80s and things like that.
The game is automatic. It's getting close, dog, look. Put it on.
Then I'ma beat it up.
Yo, the albums at the end of the R&B songs are the most important thing of everything. Like, nothing is more important than when a nigga just starts singing shit.
People always need R&B. They always need songs about positivity and love and heartbreak and things that make them feel a certain way. They want to hear things like the Chicks tape. And I never thought about it until like 2-3 years after. I was like, you know what, I'm gonna do it again because I can sing way better now. Chicks tape 1, I never even thought I was ever gonna be producing. That wasn't my thing. I was about writing songs and making songs that mattered to me. It wasn't about nothing else. Chicks tape 2 was my real breakthrough. I had no help, I had nobody. So I had to learn and pick up a sound that I wanted to create and something that I wanted to do that was different. I would take in certain music and try to listen to a different sound, try to come up with a sound of my own. And eventually, I was like, yo, I gotta produce this.
So what this is a magic piano, ladies and gentlemen, where these keys then turn into chops, where you can then place those chops and magical chops inside of your magical song. Yeah, this was supposed to be first person, but I fucked that up.
But I fucked it up.
Uh-huh. Okay, what's up?
Being on tour, I think, is the hardest part about creating a project. You know, if you're on tour while you're creating a project, you're constantly on stage performing for 20,000 people a night that want your undivided attention.
And in the back of your head, you can't stop but to keep hearing that thumping thought of, you need to finish the Chicks Tape 5 because they're not gonna let you live without you doing it.
These decisions that we make, it got me. Let me make my mind. Oh, let me take my time. Let me take my away. Let me take my time.
Chicks Tape 2, in my eyes, is still one of the most legendary and most important pieces of the puzzle because there's also a backstory